Well, you had a community information session last night in Huntsville.
We did.
Tell me a bit about that engagement first. How did that go? How are people kind of responding to what's happening right now?
Sure. We had a good turnout actually last night. Lots of members from the public were there. Lots of questions, obviously. Mm-hmm. Some concerns, some questions for, progress, kind of where we're at and what the future looks like for this project. So I would say it was a positive turnout. Lots of questions is always good. It's good to hear from people.
Yeah, I think, it's quite obvious people are impacted by this, so they want to know what's going on, right? So can you give me an idea of, I guess, some of the updates that you were providing last night?
Sure. We gave a quick presentation on just progress to date, some of the challenges we've experienced, and then kind of what the rest of November and into December could look like for construction, as well as some spring startup. And then we gave a brief update on the actual Main Street job that's coming soon.
Okay, so we kind of went over this last week, but let's do it again here. What is the, I guess, proposed time frame right now for this construction project?
Sure. Right now, we haven't seen any red flags. We're currently looking to be on track for our original end date, which was late June of 2020. Progress to date has been obviously slower from what people are seeing on the street. Some of that was we confirmed that last night at the meeting and outlined some of the challenges we've been seeing. A lot of them are related to the actual depth of the excavation itself. There was some additional rock removal that was required in there. Mm-hmm. And I think I mentioned this last time, we want to put these utilities in. We've got spacing and engineering standards now that we have to comply with that necessarily, historically they may have followed around the rock, and now we want to put it straight through. So that's taken a bit of extra time. And we've got some pretty heavy utilities running through the area there, and we want to make sure that we're accommodating these. These are all live utilities, so we want to be we'll minimize the disruption as much as possible to any services in the area. So that takes a bit of extra time and effort to work around.
I know it's hard to anticipate, but obviously this rock situation has kind of pushed back a bit. If more rock shows up in this construction, is that a possibility to push this back further again?
There is always the possibility of that in the nature of the geography we're in here. But what I can say is that they're in the deepest part of the excavation now, and as they progress towards Scott Street, that excavation is going to continually get shallower.
Okay. I mean,
if you follow the top of the road right now, you can see we are going up a hill. Mm-hmm. All the services that we're putting in are gravity fed, so this is where they outlet. We've got a sewage pumping station there as well as a storm outlet. So those are the low points. So that's the lowest we're going to be, and we want to continue to get shallower as we go up. So we're hoping that combined with some additional crews in the spring, as well as, we can work later into the winter. We'd like to work as late as possible this year. Mm-hmm. And then hopefully get an early start. We can see some acceleration in the project.
So in layman's terms, what you're saying is the majority of the work is being done on that point. Everything else is kind of uphill, I guess.
Yeah,
we literally and figuratively.
Yeah, we do start to move uphill after this point, just because of the nature of the construction itself.
Yeah.
Like we're as deep as we're getting in this area. I think they're 5 meters deep.
Okay.
At this point, that could be up to 5 feet when we start to get towards Scott Street. So it's a pretty substantial change.
Okay, and you were mentioning that there's a possibility we could be moving into December with the construction. Are we still going to see as high of disruption of traffic at that point, or is it going to kind of be toned down a bit?
We talked with the contractor, JB, who's the contractor on site right now. We're working with our design consultant, and we had asked them to kind of prepare a schedule for us that showed us what does it look like to November 30th. That was our original, what I'll call cutoff date for the winter season. Mm-hmm. It could be plus or minus on either side, so we looked to that as kind of, what are you guys going to do to November 30th? What kind of progress can we anticipate? And then we'd like to open it up, knowing we're a bit behind schedule, into December, as long as conditions are favorable as far as weather is concerned. So ideally, the section that they're in now towards Chafee, the one block that they're in essentially, can get more or less, not finalized, but able to allow for winter control through there. So we're looking at things like, pouring some concrete for the curbs and getting a base course of asphalt down.
Yeah.
Make that section passable. And then as we work past that November 30th deadline, the intent is to keep the construction zone a bit smaller. So if we get a real frost that sets in, we can button up the site pretty quick and shut down for the winter.
Okay. Biggest question on everyone's mind, I know, is this going to have any effect on the parade?
No, we've actually, that's been, we brought that up at our past couple of meetings, and we had a representative from the parade there.
Yep.
District, contractor, town, everybody's aware that the parade's coming through there. We were talking about putting some light standards in, so when they come through at night, it's a bit easier to see their way through. We're willing to hoping to get some pretty good progress between now and the end of the month, which is when the parade is, through that section that they're in now.
Yeah.
I drove through it myself today. You know, they're doing a fairly good job, or a really good job actually, in maintaining that section as passable as possible. That sounds fun to say. We know the parade's coming. That's been on our radar for a while now. So
okay. So stars align, midsummer 2020. Does that mean we could start seeing the work on the downtown Huntsville project start up around that time, or are we kind of moving forward in time with that as well?
That's been pushed back to 2021.
Okay, so that's a hard date at this point.
Yep, we went to Huntsville Council to discuss that with them.
Okay.
A few reasons for that. Some of them to allow more design, more community consultation time in 2020. Mm-hmm. Additionally, you know, we're always looking at grant opportunities, so this does give us some time to see if there's anything available that we can pursue, which mm-hmm. may help fund this project in the long term.
Speaking of grants, and I'm not sure if you can answer this or not, in terms of the financials, how are we kind of within range of what the cost of this project was so far? Are we kind of going over? Again, if I'm catching you off guard on that one.
You're talking specifically to
specifically on the King William project right now.
Budget's fine right now.
Within range?
For budget, yep. And okay. We're not forecasting any huge variances. We do build contingency amounts into all of our jobs. So in case there's some unforeseen situations, we can prepare for those financially as well.
Well, I know there was some unexpected blasting we talked about last mm-hmm. time too, right? But that's not really kind of pushing anything out of proportion at this point, no?
No, and that's an item that was built right into the contract. We knew we were going to be blasting. So
yeah.
This is just, you know, we're encountering rock in an area where you know, we wanted to send the utility straight through. We're trying to follow where the previous utilities went to minimize that blasting, but we're finding that some of them have kind of dodged around the rock. And like I said, we want to go in and make sure these things are installed to the standards that we have now. So we're going to take that rock out and make sure that these utilities run properly.
Last thing I want to reiterate again, because we did talk about this last week as well, but just to push that point home, there was communication between yourself and the MTO as well, because the Highway 11 construction that's happening, right?
Yep.
So tell me a bit about that process.
So we talk to the MTO on a fairly regular basis on multiple fronts, actually. I made a call out specifically related to this project after one of our meetings when we were having some oversized loads were detoured through the construction area, creating some challenges for us. Mm-hmm. In talking to the MTO, their work on Highway 11 is kind of nearing their closeout for the winter at this point.
Okay.
So we don't anticipate that they're going to be out there too much longer. The confirmed dates are obviously at their kind of control as far as the construction goes, but everything I'm indicating is that they're on track for their winter closeout this year. So, you know, there should be a bit of alleviation on some of the traffic congestion we're seeing through the area.
Great. Mark, thank you very much. And I know a lot of these updates are available on engagemuskoka.ca,
right.
So people can go on there and kind of see. I know you were mentioning the press points from that, the community information session will probably be posted there as well.
Yep, we'll have the slide deck up there from the presentation as well. And once again, we're open to any questions or concerns that people have either through the site or contacting us directly on them.
All right, Mark, thank you very much for coming in again. We really appreciate all the work that you're doing to keep everyone updated.